Big hair, bright colours and music television. The 1980s gave us so much, including a very special band of Kiwi ladies who can sing like angels.
Tonight we have the absolute pleasure of announcing their induction into the New Zealand Music Hall of Fame. What we need.
Five incredible women, Annie Crummer, Debbie Harwood, Diane Swan, Margaret Ehrlich and Kim Willoughby. Their solo stars were rising when they joined forces to create When the Cat's Away. The success of their number one hit, Melting Pot, was like a flower cracking through the concrete.
And the award for Television Entertainer of the Year, When the Cat's Away.
An adoring public loved their optimism and energy as they helped shape New Zealand's pop culture.
Your name will be up on these lights, your records will be played forever when you're well old and gone.
These wonderful wahine helped pave the way for female artists in Aotearoa. It appears the Cats are back, this time for good, with a legacy enshrined in the Hall of Fame.
And Diane Swan from When the Cat's Away is here now. Great to talk to you, Diane, and congratulations. So well deserved. Have you been in touch with your fellow Cats?
Thanks so much. I had a lovely chat with Kim this morning and saw Debbie just before the lockdown, but it's great to chat, and everybody's had such amazing careers and done such diverse, incredible music. It's just been great catching up. It's been really lovely.
Diane, what made the Cats work so well? What's the secret sauce?
If you think about it musically, everybody had such different voices. Like, we all came from such different parts. We all had our own bands before we joined the Cats Away, and you know, we're very, very diverse stylistically. So I think if you could listen to each and everyone's voice, you could tell who it was. But when the voices went, when we sang together, it was really, really powerful and quite a unique sound. I think pretty much musically, I think that was kind of pretty special. Plus, when we're on stage, it was a pretty hilarious show. I mean, we had a lot of laughs and there was costume changes. I just think it was really lighthearted and really fun, and I think it must have been pretty fun to be in the audience because it was great to be on stage. We had a lot of fun.
Absolutely. You're all being recognised, obviously, for your own careers too. And, Diane, you've done it all. Your band, playing with Radiohead, you've even played the Grand Old Opry in Nashville. What was that like?
Amazing. We played at the Ryman Auditorium, which is the home of the old Grand Old Opry. We were invited to go and play by this amazing country music legend, Marty Stewart, and he puts on an evening with all these incredible stars, and he invited us. He has a wild card every year, and he invited my band, The Bads, to go and play, and so we played with his band on the Ryman stage, and it was just amazing. It was just, yeah, it was one of the best moments I can think of, actually.
When was the last time you heard Melting Pot, and how does it make you feel now?
I heard it this morning on a promo for an interview, actually. It was, yeah, it's powerful, I think. Yeah, it's a really interesting song when you think about it lyrically, but very a lot of fun, a lot of energy coming from the whole band, and I think it was a really interesting interpretation of that song that was written in the 70s.
And what's next for you, Diane?
Well, I released an album, a solo album this year, called The War on Peace of Mind, and I've done some shows with my band. Obviously, it's tough for musicians at the moment knowing what's next with shows and gigs. I'm going to be doing some of the Liberty Stage shows again. We're doing Sticky Fingers, The Stones, and I hope to be doing Others Way and doing some more solo shows with my band.
Well, always lovely to see you, Diane. And please, send our congratulations on to the other Cats, won't you?
Will do. Thanks so much.
And the Aotearoa Music Awards are taking place on Friday the 17th of December on TVNZ2 and TVNZ On Demand.